Hey, Kawaro! Our topic that we are going to discuss today is about non-report and other parameters or items that we send to the owners or charterers of this vessel every non-time. But before I start my video, shout out to Fraxidio Frax, Mark Gico Tagudinay, Christian Badi, Dunalito Kaga, Yunil Batislaong, Mission Remart, Upaw Mark Bundia Villalobos, and James Sarmiento. Shout out sa inyo mga kabaro, and thanks for supporting my channel and FB page. So, sa mga hindi pa nag-like and subscribe my YouTube channel, please like and subscribe my YouTube channel. This is Chief Engineer Elrich and this is my vlog. So, good day kabaro! What are the items or the parameters that we usually report to the owners or charterer every non-time? So these items or parameters is only for the engine side, and I won't discuss the some parameters of the bridge that they report on the owners or charterer. So this video that I made is almost intended to bulk carrier vessels because I'm working with the bulk carrier since 2009. So maybe with the tankers or the containers, we have the same reporting that we made every noon, or not only noon. So just for example, if you have charterer, they have different form or different method of reporting than the owner. So we have to send two reporting per day for the owner side and for the charterer side. Charterer, because in chartered vessel, the owner of the fuel and diesel is the charterer. Actually, kabaro, on board we have different kinds of reporting. So these are departure reporting. So what is departure reporting? When we depart from port. Example, we already finished or discharging or loading the cargo on this port. So we have to send departure condition report. Actually, in our company Cabarro, we send the departure report as start of sea passage. So that is the company form departure report, start of sea passage. So departure, and then at sea, we have non-report. So we have non-report at sea. So this is from noon to noon basis. And then arrival report. Arrival report, we do this on end of sea passage. So this is before we arrive on port. And at port, we have also noon to noon basis report. So that is for owner or charterer. Some of the charterers, they have different kind of reporting when the vessel is in port. They have sometimes they have 0800 reporting or 10000 reporting and 1700 reporting. Usually in charterer reporting, we always do the fuel consumption and diesel consumption and the ROV of these two, fuel and diesel. So now, kabaro, what are the parameters or items that we send to the owner or charterers every non-departure or arrival reporting? So these are the first is the main engine and diesel generator parameters. So these are usually the engine temperature, pressure, so that kind of reportings. So the second one is the fuel, diesel oil and log oil consumption. What are the consumption from noon to noon basis reporting, or from noon to arrival or noon to departure reporting? So third is the FO or fuel oil, diesel oil and log oil ROB, so or remaining on board. The fourth one is the main engine RPM. The fifth one is the engine distance, then engine slip percentage, and then engine power by kilowatt, through or by fuel consumption basis. And the last one is the maximum continuous output load. This is load. Percentage. So the last one is MCO, maximum output load percentage. So today, I will show you how to compute this following item that I write here. So except for main engine MDG parameters, because we only read this on the engine body itself. So now, Kabaro, we'll go on how to compute the fuel consumption on board. So, fuel consumption on board in metric ton. Always compute the fuel or diesel on board in metric ton, Kabaro. So, consumption in metric ton is equals to flow meter present minus flow meter previous equals total in cubic meter or liter. So, it depends on your flow meter. So, there are some flow meters that it gives liters or flow meters that already give in cubic meter. Right here, metric tons consumption is equals to cubic meters times fuel oil correction factor. So, I have already a video on how to take the fuel oil correction factor. So, you have to go back in my previous video how to compute the fuel correction factor of the fuel. How about if your flow meter is in liter? So, you have to convert the total consumption in cubic meter. So, 1 cubic meter is equals to 1,000 liters, Kabaro. So, you have to divide by 1,000. Your flow meter gives in liters. So, cubic meters times fuel oil correction factors is equals to metric ton. For example, this is our present non-flow meter. So, this is non-to-non basis. Or, example, you compute the arrival computation. So, you have to compute from non to time of arrival. 1306.94, and this is the previous flow meter. So, 1306.94 as the present flow meter minus 1287.44 as the previous flow meter is equals to 19.5 cubic meter. So, in order to compute the consumption as per metric ton, 19.5 cubic meter times 0.91 as example correction factor, this is the correction factor of the fuel, is equals to 17.75 metric ton consumption. So, this is your metric ton consumption regardless how many hours did the engine run. So, example, the engine runs for 24 hours. So, this is the 24 hours consumption of your engine. Every vessel, Kabaro, there are different types of flow meter design. Sometimes there are some vessels that there is a flow meter for inlet and there is flow meter from outlet. So you have to minus the flow meter from inlet flow meter. So I'm just computing here the flow meter of this vessel. So you don't need to follow this procedure. Maybe your vessel have different flow meter design. So, just for example, you have a flow meter that has an inlet and outlet. So, you have to compute based on your vessel's flow meter design. So, this is the total fuel consumption. So, there are some Japanese vessels that the fuel line of diesel generator and main engine is separated. So, you have to compute the fuel or fuel consumption of the generator and the fuel consumption of main engine. So, this vessel, the design of this vessel, the consumption of main engine and generator is in together line. So this is the total consumption of main engine and generator. So you have to minus the consumption of generator here in this total consumption. So remember, Kabaro, in every vessel, we have different kinds of flow meter design. So you don't need to follow this procedure or else you will have a wrong fuel consumption on board. For example, this vessel, we don't have an outlet flow meter, but we only have an inlet flow meter. So we only have to minus the present and the previous flow meter. So that is the total consumption. So this is the total consumption of main engine and generator because they are in the same fuel lines. What if we have to compute the consumption of main engine? How do we know that this is the consumption of main engine? On this vessel, I only base my generator consumption on sea trial report. Just for example, the sea trial report says that at 300 kilowatt, this is the consumption of generator. So that is the basis that I am following. So for example, total consumption 17.75, total x equals to main engine plus dg. So this is a total consumption of main engine and generator. How about if I compute the main engine is equals to total minus dg at 300 kilowatt. For example, this day 300 kilowatt. So the consumption as per sea trial is 2.0. So I have to minus 2.0 from 17.75. So the consumption of my main engine is 17.75 metric ton. So I'm just only guessing the consumption of my generator. So what we are going to do? So because the generator has no flow meter and only the main engine has flow meter, so we are only guessing the consumption of generator because it has no flow meter. For example, we are using two generator and the sea trial report of the engine says that if the kilowatt of this generator is 150, they are consuming 1.5 tons and the other is 1.5, so we have to plus this one. So 3 metric tons per day. Simple tips, Kabaro, we don't only rely our consumption and flow meter because sometimes this flow meter malfunctioned or it got damaged. So how about if you run only, the engine only is running for 100 RPM and you consume 20 tons, which is abnormal. So that is abnormal consumption. So we don't rely the consumption of engine based on flow meter only. So we have to see the sea trial report of the engine. In every engine RPM, there is a fuel consumption, Kabaro. So just for example, 100 RPM, how much is the consumption of the engine on this RPM? So that is stated on the sea trial report. So you have to compute 25% load, this is the RPM, 50% load, this is the RPM, 75% load, this is the RPM, and 100% load, this is the RPM of the engine. So based on RPM, there is a consumption of the engine. So remember that, Kabaro. Remember, Kabaro, in order to avoid troubles for the owners and charterers, when you putting the consumption, always check the sea trial reports in order to avoid this kind of trouble. So just for example, you are only running in 100 RPM and your consumption is above that RPM. So you report it in the owner, you make a report it to the charterer, and then they will see it. How come does the engine consume with this kind of consumption that the engine is running only with 100 RPM? Please look at the previous report of previous chief engineer, what are the consumption of this engine on this RPM, or you have to see the sea trial report of the engine. So, at here, on the other side, we have here or charter agreement or charter party agreement. So, remember, Kabaro, if the vessel is chartered, the owner and the charterer has an agreement of engine consumption per day. Example, in charter party agreement, we have here, ballast condition. At full speed, equals 18.5 metric ton per day at 40 knots. So, this vessel's RPM at full speed is 125 RPM. So, at 125 RPM, you must have only 18.5 metric tons consumption per day. This is included the generator. So, main engine and generator must have only 18.5 metric ton per day at 14 knots speed of the vessel. So, you cannot go on 18.5 or more. Compute the 1% of 18.5 and you can put additional 1% of this 18.5 for your total consumption. But, you cannot go on farther on that consumption. This 40 knots can only be attained if we have good external forces like force of the wind is only force 3, we have no adverse current, and we have fair weather or no waves at all. But if we have strong wind like force 5 or force 4, and we have some adverse current, we cannot follow this 40 knots. So, that is understandable for the charterer if we have bad weather on board. So, that is for full speed. How about if the charterer told us, okay, run the vessel in economical speed. So, if the vessel is in economical speed, the charter agreement, for example, is 14 metric ton per day at 12.5 knots. So, example, this vessel, the economical speed of this is 112 RPM. So, you have to run the vessel in 112 or you have to run it to attain this 12.5 knots at fair and good weather. You cannot exceed your consumption if you are in economical speed at 14 metric ton per day. You can only add 1% of this 14 metric ton. How about in loading condition or loaded condition? We have also different charter agreement and loaded condition. At full speed, the consumption is 20 metric. This is only an example of this vessel, Kabaro. At full speed, the consumption is 20 metric ton per day at 30 knots. So, you have to attain this consumption 20 metric ton per day at 30 knots. Economical speed example, 15 metric ton day at 12 knots. This is an example. How about import? Import without crane, if we don't use the crane, if the vessel has crane, 3.0 metric ton per day. So, this is the total consumption of generator and because in port, we are using boiler. So, this is total consumption. DG and boiler at total of 3.0 metric ton per day. How about in port with crane? We are using the crane, the cargo. We are using the crane to load the cargo or discharge the cargo. So, the consumption, for example, is 5 metric ton per day because we are using crane and we are using 2 or 3 generator. So, the consumption is more higher, 5.0 metric ton. This is an example of charter agreement of this vessel, Kabaro. So, note, in fuel consumption, 0.1 metric ton of diesel added or SMGO. So, per day, if you are consuming fuel, then you have last consumption of 0.1 metric ton for the DO. So now, Kabaro, what are we using as per our consumption per day? Actually, Kabaro, this flow meter is only for reference purposes if we are in bulk with charter party agreements. So we don't use this whole flow meter thing anymore. This is just only a reference for consumption. We always base our consumption on charter party agreement. So this is just only a reference. We don't use this actual flow meter consumption anymore. We base our consumption in charter party agreement. We always follow on what owner and charterer party agreement. If the vessel is in ballast condition, we have to follow this consumption in ballast condition agreement. If the vessel in loaded or lading condition, we have to follow this charter party agreement. In port, if we are using crane, we have to follow this consumption. Without crane, we are following this consumption. Anyway, Kabaro, this 18.5 per day, metric ton per day, this is the whole total consumption. Huh? Main engine, generator, or using boiler at sea, this is total consumption per day. Plus 0.1 metric ton of diesel. This is an example of charter party agreement consumption. Maybe on tankers or in the container, I don't know what are the fuel consumption agreement of the charterer. Because here in bulk, I've been working in bulk for a long time, and this is almost the same for charter party agreement for the fuel and diesel consumption. So that's all for the fuel consumption, Kabaro.